Okay. Tell me how you came to Butte.
Come to Butte 1922. Because my father sent us, you know, we were in the old country, and my father sent for us, the whole three of us, my mother. So we come to Butte. When we come to Butte, we stay with Weedy brothers, you know, for a week. And then we went up in Elkhorn. We took up in Elkhorn because my father was listening. He was looking for ore. Anyhow, so we went up there, and my father, every time they sent a car or ore to Helena, and he had to pay money. So he didn't make no money, he went broke. So we were absolutely broke. He didn't have a penny to send my sister penny. But he didn't want to come down here and build because he thought someday he's going to strike a rich. But after all, the bills were, you know, were coming up and coming up. But Mary only stayed up there about, my sister Mary only stayed up there about 6 months. Connie about 8 months. And then none of us come up. So finally we had to come to build. And so he could go to work in the mine, you know. So we come to Butte, my father started working at Leonard Mine, and he got hurt. And then he had a heart condition. And 4 years he never worked again. Never worked. So, and finally died, you know. So we had to work. While we were living in Meadowell, I went to work. I was about, not quite 14 years, 13 and a half. Because we only stayed up there a year and a year and a half, you know, after that, not even. But anyhow, and then I went to work for this guy that he had his hand, you know, he had his hand cut off. And he got hurt in the mine, and so he had those, hooks.
Oh yeah, hooks for hands.
So I went to work and helped this woman. I was doing the dishes. In fact, I went over there to do the dishes. But I was getting paid almost $1.50 a day. That was a lot of money. So I started to cook there with this little old lady. But I knew a little bit how to cook because my mother taught me. When I was a little girl in your country, because over there you don't pray except once on Sunday.
Yeah.
You know. And then my mother, she started something. Then she said to me, "You watch, so it won't burn, and do this and put this in." So you got to learn how to do the cooking.
Yeah.
And then while I was working at Mike's Law, this lady, she taught me how, a little bit, you know. But I didn't know anything about a restaurant, you know, because I don't even know what a restaurant was just about. Once in a while. And so then after that, I went to work for Panchetta, the White House. They used to give free dinners away. You know what you got on my place? You used to get free.
Oh, why?
Just so you bought a bottle of wine.
Oh.
Cigarette. Or gambling. That's all. Anybody could have anything to eat. So I learned a little bit there with this other woman, Maggie. And, but anyhow, I got so that I really liked to cook. And from then on, after day goes, I went to work for, Joe Sinistrato, what they call that place. But anyhow, I went to work there and I started. And you learn, as you go along, you learn how to cook. Because I only done dishes for about 6 months. After that, I got to be a salad girl and then cookie. So from that on, then I went to across the street, another place they used to get, called Paris Place. And I worked there with that woman, Mrs. Perham, and I learned a lot there too. for the restaurant, you know.
Uh-huh.
But I know my cooking. I really do. And they didn't do anything different. In fact, I had to show them how to make gravy better than what they were doing. So anyhow, from there I went to, again, there, I was never fired. And so I went across the street, used to call them Alaska Cafe.
Uh-huh.
And we stayed there, I stayed there at work, and I was making pretty good money. And then they closed it up. And then I went back working for Teddy at the parish at the Rocky Mountain. And I worked there for about 8 years.
Mm-hmm.
And I was the only cook. So, you know, nobody to teach me.
No,
I was all alone. So anyhow, I stayed there, and then I finally got mad. And I quit. So I went over across the street, and I went and partnered with Sonny O'Day. And then after that, he went to war, and then this other guy, you know, split up, the business split up. So finally, there was this place down the flat, you know, they used to call it the casino,
uh-huh.
And this woman, Mrs. Sylvain, says it's up for sale. You know, somebody told me it was up for sale. So I went down and I talked to her, and you know, I asked if she was willing to sell it. She says, oh yes, she wanted to get out of the business because, you know, her and her husband were getting pretty old. She says, I'd like to buy it, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So I bought it. And she didn't think I was going to stay there. She really thought I was going to move up.
Uh-huh.
And so I stayed there, and I worked myself up, and every year my business started growing and growing and growing.
Uh-huh.
And that's the way it started. And so finally, I had it going pretty good.
Yeah.
You know, the way I wanted.
Yeah.
And then we started remodeling, do things different, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And that's it.
Well, how in Butte, though, you mean for a woman to own a business like that was a pretty was an unusual thing. I mean, so there were some things that must have been.
Well, I had to go out and work because I didn't have any money,
uh-huh.
And I had to keep my mother and two brothers.
Yeah,
my brother Talo and my brother Dave.
Yeah,
see, my father, he was broke, yeah. And I had to pay his bill.
Yeah,
that he left behind.
Yeah,
so I didn't miss a day of work all my life.
Yeah.
Until I quit.
Yeah. How long were your days, and what kinds of things did you have to do?
Everything. Make a ravioli by hand.
Yeah.
Gravy. Clean chicken them days. You know, for a long time you had to clean your own chicken because it wasn't as easy. You know, clean now, they all come real clean and everything,
yeah.
You know. But before we used to clean and chop them and everything.
Yeah.
And then you learn how, you know, that's it. You had to work real hard. And you don't work only 8 hours.
Mm-hmm.
You work 16 hours and 7 days a week.
Yeah.
I had to, because I owned the place.
Yeah.
And then you keep on working, and, you know, that's it.
Well, restaurants it's hard to keep a restaurant going as a business. So
yeah.
You must have had a real good business sense, too.
Well, I really improved on my cooking.
Uh-huh.
And my cooking, and the food, like I said, was cheap in the day, you know. In fact, when I got the place down the flat,
mm-hmm.
They didn't think I was going to make it. In fact, they had, you see, they liked the way I was cooking, and I built up my nice reputation even when I was at the Rocky Mountain.
Mm-hmm.
See, I built up my good reputation because I was the only cook, and I done a good job.
Mm-hmm.
And so finally, I thought, well, I'm quick, you know. When I went down there, a lot of people didn't believe I could make it, but they did like it. They did like the cooking.
Mm-hmm. Oh, delicious.
Yeah. And so I went down there, and I keep, you know, work hard, and you know, every day that you cook, you learn something new, too.
Mm-hmm.
Or you read in the book, you can come up, you know, kind of fix it up a little bit. Different, but you must know that you gotta be use good stuff. Mm-hmm. Fresh stuff and good food, you know, good quality of meat and good quality of food, that's what you need. Uh-huh. And then if you cook right, then your customer's gonna come every day. Yeah, you see, the customer used to come. And I really built up to a nice, then it was pretty busy, you know, that was a normal place. Uh-huh. And somebody, the carpenter told me, he says, you know, if you don't do something about this place, it's going to give in. Because now, your business is getting big, a lot of people coming in, and the foundation wasn't any good there. So that's when I turned around, once when we thought about building a new place. Mm-hmm. And David, you know, we built a new place. And we treat our customers real nice. Mm-hmm. And when I was there. Oh, they still
do. Oh, they still do.
And, you know, we put ourselves out for our customer. And the customer's always right. Uh-huh. So the people got to like us. And that's the way it went, you know.
Enjoy the kind of life you had, or?
Yeah, I did. I enjoyed it at the beginning, but then I couldn't quit because I was stuck with it, you know.
Yeah.
And nobody would buy it. I was stuck, and then, like, again, I had to keep my mother.
Yeah.
I had to keep David. I had to keep a fellow with that hand, you know. Mm-hmm. Send him to school, and, I mean, I kept the four of us,
yeah.
And nothing else is coming in. I had to.
Yeah, that's a big responsibility.
Oh, that was too much. I said, now I can see. I can go back and see what I think I done. I thought about everybody else, but for myself.
Yeah.
And now I can see because I know that I burned myself out being down there too many hours. Mm-hmm. If I only knew. Life of one, just to say, could I get a couple of days off like they do now and enjoy it? You don't get so intense, right?
Right.
And that's it.
Yeah, some people burn themselves out having a good time, though. It's bad to
yeah.
Maybe burn
well,
yourself out.
Yeah, well, I mean, I never did go out for a good time. I never went to a dance.
Yeah, because you didn't have time.
I know, I didn't have time. And then, I mean, they all had music. You know, them days, everybody had a band, it was dancing all night, you know. Mm-hmm. Then you see, you just don't pay no more attention. Because mm-hmm. you see a lot of people in the dance hall and everything, you know. It kind of makes you feel, well, I don't care for it. Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, that's the way it was. I won't do that again.
What would you do differently?
I work eight hours a day. I'm not going to work 16.
Yeah.
And I think I would have got more help. But I didn't want more help because I need the money.
Uh-huh.
See, the kids growing up, and my mother was sick all the time. The only time I took day off when I took her to Rochester. Nobody, my sister couldn't help them. Mm-hmm. I was the only one because I was single. And they all depend on me.
But that doesn't seem fair just because you're single.
Yeah, but to them it's fair. You betcha. It is fair, you know, for them. But because I was living with my mother.
Yeah.
Yeah. And we never had to go to the WPA.
Yeah.
We never had to go for food or anything because they got enough. My mother enjoyed her life and both of the kids, but except me, I enjoy my work.
Yeah.
Yeah, right.
But that's, yeah, this doesn't seem very fair.
No, it wasn't. But I was dumb too, you know. To think, I don't know why I worried about them and I didn't worry about myself a little bit more.
Mm-hmm.
And I didn't. But it was a little bit too much. But I'm glad it's over with. Maybe that's why now I don't feel that good. Maybe I did burn myself out. And it was time not for me to walk. I was so tired. When I go home, I was so tired, I couldn't even pick up my clothes. Yeah. And I go home, take a hot bath, and tell started to take a hot bath, and then I get up in the morning to wake up. I took another, well, not a hot bath, F cool and F. So I can't wake up. Now, and then I wake up, go to about 11 o'clock, I have my coffee, and then at 2 o'clock I have to go back to work.
Oh, God.
And then you work, sometimes you don't come home till 5, 6 o'clock in the morning. Morning like that.
Oh, but you know about how many people you'd serve in a day, usually like when you had the regular customers coming every single day?
Well, we only stay open for the customers. Now they don't even stay open 8 hours. Mm-hmm. But sometimes on Saturday and Sunday, about close to 1,000.
Oh, my.
But 800.
How could you have kept track, I mean, and know how much food to cook?
You got the reservation. You get so that you just about can tell.
Because that's a hard thing for a lot of...
Yeah, it is. Well, I just keep on cooking, well, like the spaghetti and stuff we cook, and sometimes we go along. But the gravy, we make a whole batch, you know, batches and batches of gravy.
Yeah.
So it can last us for a week.
Yeah.
And if it sometimes don't last, then we make some more. But if it's real busy, and then, I mean, great big parts of gravy. Mm-hmm. As long as you had the gravy and you had the ravioli.
You were set.
I was set. Because this spaghetti you can always cook. And the chicken we used to send for F. Carol at the time.
Oh, God. A lot of chicken to clean.
You bet. At them days, and now when I was down there, anyhow, you used to come clean. But Danny Miro didn't.
No.
We had to clean them all.
Oh, yeah.
In them days. And Danny, you know, when I was down the flat, then they all come clean. But that's what happened.
What part of Italy did your family come from?
It's close to Rome. The province of Ancona. You heard that?
Yes.
Yeah, that's mm-hmm. all. Close to Ancona, about not even 8 miles from here to town.
Mm-hmm.
That's it, from Ancona.
Was it hard to leave when you were little, or were you excited?
I tell you the truth, my sisters were excited, but not me. Yeah. Maybe if I had a hunch I was going to be. I was going to be not such, you know, my life wasn't going to be too good. Nothing but hard work. No, I enjoyed being over there because we had five towards the end. I had a lot more friends and it was more, you know.
Uh-huh.
You get older, you got a lot more, you know.
Uh-huh.
You enjoy it more. But when we were living out in the country, them days you had to stay home. Like I said, just on Sunday,
mm-hmm.
and you go out maybe play for a little bit. But during the week, you had to do your chore, no matter how old you are, 5 or 6 years old, you have to do it.
Oh, God.
They teach you. I wasn't the only one, but everybody in that little town. Then when we moved to town, then that was different.
Mm-hmm.
And my mother was a very good cook. And so was my father.
Uh-huh.
And then I learned lots more when we were up in Alcorn because he wasn't working. And on Sunday, him and I used to cook. And he taught me a lot. Different dishes.
Uh-huh.
Now I forgot. Uh-huh. But you know how to cook wild fowl, you know, chicken and stuff like that, wild meat and stuff like that.
Yeah.
He really taught me how, and they were delicious. But now I don't even know what to start from, you know.
Mm-hmm.
I don't even know how to start it again. You do forget. I used to say to my mother, Mom, why don't you make this and that? She said, oh, baby, I forgot. I don't even know what you're talking about. And I thought, oh, boy, maybe she don't want to do it. But now I can see she was right.
Uh-huh.
She was like, I forgot everything.
What was one of the funniest things that has happened to you in owning Lydia's?
Huh?
What's one of the funniest things that have happened to you?
Tell you the truth, nothing was funny.
Nothing was funny?
Nothing. You had to work, that's all I know. It was, I was serious and I meant. do something, just hard work. And then you get